In this video, we're going to be reviewing the BougeRV 53 quart portable fridge freezer. So if you watched my last fridge review video, you're going to notice that aesthetically that the BougeRV is very similar, and it's made out of ABS plastic and has actually, I want to say not identical, but very close style handles. They have that strong spring back, and I would say that they're pretty strong, pretty high quality, which is what you're going to want when you're tying this down. Because these are going to act as your tie-down points for the fridge. This is a 53-quart fridge, and what that's going to mean for you is if you're putting 12-ounce cans in there, you're going to be able to hold about 72 of these 12-ounce cans, just so you guys have an idea of the storage capacity. BougeRV sort of breaks this into liters. I know it's 53 quarts, but it's like 50 liters, they say. 40 liters in the bigger section and 10 liters in the smaller. So if you're using this as a freezer, you'll only have 10 liters available to not freeze. Dimensions on this are about 22 inches long, it's about 14 inches wide, and 20 inches tall. You do get a little bit more with the handles being on, so you're going to be closer to around 26 inches with the handles installed. This weighs in at just over 38 pounds, and actually, we are going to test that.
34.3 pounds.
It's actually coming in under the 38 pounds, so I guess that's nice when it's 4 pounds lighter than what they claim. Just like about every other fridge on the market, this will run on both 12 and 24 volt DC, which will be your vehicle, your batteries, or your portable power station. It'll also run on 120 volt or 240 volt AC. Pretty standard, but pretty nice that you can plug it in at your house, cool it down before you throw it in your Jeep. On the max settings, they're claiming it's going to be about 60 watts. And on the Eco, it's going to be about 45, which is a little bit higher than the last fridge that we reviewed. But you do also need to keep in mind that this fridge is coming in at just almost currently half the price. As of the date of this recording, this is retailing on Amazon for $299. So this is a budget fridge, and it's pretty big. You might have to sacrifice your power consumption for affordability. I mean, you get what you pay for. That doesn't mean this is a bad fridge in any means, but we're going to test that out, and the Blue Eddy is going to show us exactly how much power that's drawing, so we'll be able to let you guys know if their claims are accurate. So we'll do that in a second. Specs on this are that they are claiming that it can run at a 30 degree incline, which is pretty good. Most of your off-roading, you probably won't get to about a 30 degree incline. I think when we were in Moab, we hit 30 or just over 30 degrees on a couple of pretty steep climbs. So good to know that this fridge will keep running when you're out there on the trail at those severe inclines. And you're probably not going to be at those inclines for very long. So this fridge should be able to handle that. Also, they are claiming for noise, 45 decibels. And we are really going to test that here in a second as well. Something that's a little different is this doesn't have any actual buttons. So you're not pushing on anything. These are touch capacitive buttons. Which so far in my initial testing have worked fine. So I don't have any complaints personally. I do prefer a physical button, but this has been holding up great. It opens this way, which as you guys can see, takes up quite a bit more space instead of it opening up this way. So there is a space consideration to think about when you're mounting your fridge, unless you have it on a slide where you can pull it out and space isn't an issue. You see the fitment on that isn't the best. So it was a little, it's a tight fit, which isn't a bad thing, but it gets caught on these lips in here. So when you go to pull it out, that can be a little bit annoying. It's not an end of the world sort of thing. It has a divider, which is nice. In here also you'll notice instead of plastic, a plastic strap, they have a little metal chain, which is kind of cool. I kind of like that. There's also we got a light in here, which we'll show a little bit more later when we fire this thing up for the first time. And they do also list inside, they have a little chart for different temperatures for different things, which is nice. Once again, pretty standard, but at least you have that chart here so you can reference whatever you're trying to keep cool in here. This latch is totally fine. But you see that? I'm dropping that and it's not latching, which It just requires a little push. Once again, not a big deal. But just keep that in mind that you can't see that time it got. But I'm not really one to want to be like slamming it anyway. So it's for me, it's not personally an issue because I'm just gonna close it by hand. But there are better latches out there that kind of latch a little easier. On the back of the unit, you'll notice, which is pretty standard as well, instead of two different plugs, they just have the one plug for DC and AC, which is cool. You have your battery protection levels here, which is nice. There isn't an... If this was to bump on something, there's nothing to protect the cord or the switch from possibly getting bumped. Once again, not the biggest deal for me because I'm not going to have it sliding around in my vehicle. But just keep that in mind, that there's nothing out here to protect. Once again, pretty minor thing, but just something to note. Let's also talk about a couple of the other accessories that are included. Pretty standard. You're going to get your AC power brick. Pretty standard there. And they're going to give you a pretty long 12-volt cigarette lighter plug, which should be pretty good. You can get a little bit ways away from your power source. Also, one thing I really wanted to compliment BougeRV on is check out this tool that they give you. I know it's just an Allen tool, but when you're installing the handles, this is like a kind of nice, like I don't want to throw this away. So like when you're going to put this on here, you can really, I don't know. It was just nice. All these companies, usually they give you those cheap little Allen tools that are so small and they break and you want to throw them away. I don't know. This is nicer. So, for me, I mean, minor thing, but I'm happy with that. They're saying a 2-year warranty from date of purchase. So, keep that in mind. This thing's been in here for a couple weeks. It's at room temperature, which is about 70 degrees in here. Currently, this thing is on max mode, and we are going to check the wattage first, how many watts it's pulling. We have it set to 37 degrees, trying to get down to 37 degrees. So we'll check here over on the Blue Eddy EB70. And this is actually interesting, because currently, as you guys can see, it's only pulling 34 watts. 35. I suspect that this number will start climbing, as you can see, going up 36, 37. This will let you guys know where this taps out at. It's probably going to be in the 60 range, like they claimed. But originally, it started, and it's in the 40s now. So a slow ramp up, which is kind of interesting. How long it's taking to get up to max, which is fine with me. But I just thought it would kick on a little sooner. But it looks like it's climbing. Hear that? Let's jump over to our decibel test while we're here. All right, so about 48 decibels from about a foot away. And if we were to go back to, usually these manufacturers, they make their decibel readings at like 3 feet or, you know, a little further away because it kind of helps them out. So 48 from a foot, from about 3 feet, we'll see what it's at. So that was about 43 decibels. So their 45 decibel claim is fairly accurate. It just depends on where they're measuring it from. Now let's check back in on our power usage while we're here. So you can see that wattage is climbing up to 53 watts. And we are going to let you guys know where that taps out at. And then we're gonna switch the fridge over to eco mode so we can see how little watts it pulls on eco. And this guy's been running for quite a while now, and I've been monitoring it. It doesn't go over 60 watts. 58 to 60, it kind of hovers between that range. It really liked 59. As you can see, it's holding 60 watts steady now. So eco mode bumps it down to about 40 watts. And that bumped down pretty quick. So 39, 40 watts. We'll monitor this. I'll let you know if this ends up going above 40. Compressor just kicked off. But we set it to 37 degrees, timed that out, and it took 27 minutes and 45 seconds to go from 70 degrees to 37. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take this down to 0 degrees, to freezer temperature, and then we're going to resume this so you guys can see how long it takes to go from room temperature 70 degrees down to zero. All right, so temperature readings. 29 at the bottom, 42, or 29 on the side, 42 on the bottom, 20, 30 on that wall. This one's reading 18, and then this one is reading 19. And then in the upper compartment, looks like 62. And also, you guys can see the light in action there. Down to zero. Alright, so the compressor just kicked off, and as you guys can see, we're at 0 degrees. And it looks like our time was 1 hour, 3 minutes, and 33 seconds. And let's pop this guy open. Woo, that's chilly. Let's get a couple temp readings in here. The bottom, we're reading at 8, sides at 2 degrees, 0 on that one. This one's reading negative 2. And this wall is at negative 1. And then the upper compartment here is reading at like 44 degrees. That is not a bad time at all to go from 70 degrees down to 0. Now, we are going to start what I call our long-term test here. And we're going to set the fridge to 37 degrees, which is mainly how I intend to use it. And we're going to power it still off of the Blue Eddy. And I'm going to put that in the Jeep and leave it in the Jeep and see how many hours we can get out of it. And it's going to be on eco mode. Should be able to at least get a couple days out of it for sure. But the next time you guys see me, I'll have an update on how long that took and my final impressions, and we'll sort of break everything down.
It has been a few weeks since I've been testing this now, since I was last here. And that long-term test with the Blue Eddy, I was able to get right around 50 and a half hours of runtime off of the Blue Eddy EB70. And so that's not bad, over 2 days of only running off of that. I would say that the BougeRV fridge at that price point is a great entry-level fridge. It's probably not gonna be the one you're going to stick with forever, but maybe you're wanting to get one and you don't wanna spend $500, $600, $700, $800 on a fridge, $1,000. At that price point, I don't think you can really go wrong with it. Once again, this is not a long-term test, so I can't speak for the long-term durability of it, but you know, initial impressions, it seems very comparable to a lot of other fridges on the market, and I have no problem running this fridge. I'm gonna continue to use this. I would picture this as a great, like, kind of a stepping stone, getting into the BougeRV to start, maybe using it for a year or two and then selling it, recoup some of your costs, and then maybe get something a little more efficient. Because for me, the biggest downside is the energy consumption. Because ideally I'd like to get as many hours as all you guys, I'm sure too, out of your power supply. So that's mainly how I'm gonna be using it. So if you just keep in mind, if you're trying to take something like this on a long trip, you could totally do it, but you just need to swap between, while you're in your vehicle, plug it into your vehicle. You know, and then your power supply will get you through the rest of the time. So it's really not too big of a deal. And you know, it's a very affordable fridge. So that's gonna do it for this one, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in one of my other fridge reviews, I'll have that here. Maybe if you wanna watch a wheeling video, have maybe something over here for you guys. I'll see you guys in the next one.